And I'm happy that the first talk is a good fit to the lightning talk we to the talk we heard before. We heard that the current research infrastructure is broken because of large companies, and Patrick Korstenbach and his team from Belgium and Netherlands will show an alternative to it with an open research infrastructure. So we welcome Patrick. Stage is yours.
Thank you, Jakob. Well, the first thing I need to say is that I really miss to be with you all in this big rooms and having a chance to talk with all of you. This is a very long two years without a real library social interaction, but I hope this talk will give a bit of an enlightenment what I did the last year. And indeed, like Jakob said, this talk, well, I didn't need a very long introduction, because indeed what Professor Laudan said, well, this is really what we did in the last year, and trying to find a solution. What can be done with this fact that we are living in this world of big publishers that do all kind of things with your data you really don't know? And this we reflected in the title of our talk, the using linked data notifications to assemble the scrolling record on the decentralized web. And that is something I am doing with my co-workers and co-researchers, Ruben de Dekker, Miel van der Sande, Jeroen Werbroek and Herbert van der Sample, and Jeroen Verborg, Ruben Verborg, excuse me. Next slide. So this is research that is sponsored by the Mellon, and it is started in 2020, but because of the Corona crisis, we got an extra year, and it's all based on the research that Herbert van der Sample did since the 1990s, and because from a very early stage, it was already known in for library techies that something was going in the wrong direction. How publications got on the web, how was very fast and a huge concentration of all this service in a few library vendors, and that was called the serial crisis with costs of journals rising every year with crazy amounts. So if you want to learn more about the vision that Herbert has and still is based on what we are doing in this Mellon project, I advise you to watch his 270 CNI lecture. There are also related things, what we are doing, and it's what the people doing at Core Notify. It's all around peer review in the F-Good sector. It's about memory institutions that want to share data, but also in the subject of architecture and buildings. So what we are trying to do can be very well reflected in what the core vision is of what the next generation repository should look like. And I copied here just a piece of text from the mission statement, what Core wrote down. What do we really need in the future to solve this, to solve the problems that Professor Laudan talked about? And I highlighted the important words here. It's about distributed and globally networked infrastructure, and it should be made for the scholarly community. And on top of these things, we need to add layers and added services that we are deploying ourselves for our own world. These things have to be research centric and managed by us, the scholarly community. Of course, this is a very utopian thing that we are thinking about. But in the light of what we heard in the keynote, it is important that we start already experimenting with these technologies and see how far we can go to solve this very dear problems we have. These problems are really not new. That is already addressed in the keynote. Already, Tim Berners-Lee is very stressing the not the decentralization, but really the decentralization of the web. Because this all not happened suddenly. It's already when the internet was started in 1996 or 1968, the internet was built like in this open community without borders, and everyone could have access to this this internet. And it also was in the World Wide Web that Tim Berners-Lee invented in the 1990s. Also there, it was a very open web, and it had to give all the people the chance to share the data with the vision of a very utopian leveling of the society. But what we saw is that it's not really happened. You saw already the big portals that are dominating the web, and the server is of course very free, but you are being sold on the web. If you are already in one of these portals, it's very hard to move the data, and there's also hardly any kind of interoperability between all these services. So there's an example where it says, well, if I want to move my LinkedIn data to Facebook and connect it with these images I got on Instagram or on a Flickr account, it is very hard because all the data is really locked in this platforms, and you can't move this. So if you say, well, Instagram has a very nice way to display all my artworks, can they also use this in LinkedIn? No, this is really tied into one of these platforms. That is not different from what we see in our world, but which is always already addressed in the keynotes. We are really dominated by this massive publishers, or we can't say that there are publishers these days. Of course, the service is very smooth, but free, I wouldn't say it is a very free service. You see these paywalls everywhere. You have to pay the APCs to get things published there. There's a really a transfer of all your rights to the publishers. There is no standard APIs for reviewing, annotating, indexing, searching, and archiving. And all these services are really tied to one of these platforms. You can't easily switch between these services. This thing you already saw in the keynotes, and the question is this picture okay? Is this what we really want? Is this the most ideal solution? I hope you say no, but what we are trying to do in the Mellon is trying to see if we can find a way to re-decentralize this web. The idea is there that we are going to give to all the researchers a research pod environment where they are in full control of the data they are producing, like their publications, their data sets, everything you can imagine. And we also are building a decoupled way so we can do all the core functionalities of what you need in the scholarly publication, like registration, peer review, archivation. Everything could be built with decentralized services. and all need to be standard based. Of course, it will make it a bit more constraining, because standards means you need to have a way to have an interoperable way to talk with other people. But still, we are trying to do this. Of course, this is very technical focus. There is also a social aspect, but we are working on the technical focus. So what does it look like? Well, you have all these researchers here, Alice, Bob, and Charlie. They deposit their publications or the data sets in their personal data pod here on their personal DNS name. So if you move to another university, you still keep all your data on the same URI. And then we are trying to build, based on this data, create interoperable service between your pods and the rest of the world that are creating this service hubs in a decoupled way. So for example, a researcher can say, well, I need to have a registration of my publication or the dataset. Well, this can be done by your institutional repo. It can be reviewed, and there are now all over the world, they are starting this decoupled review services. Also, you could say, I want to have my publication in a web archive, and all the functionalities what you need can be on different parts of the network. Okay, my video is still okay, I hope, and the sound. Well, how we do this is we are sending linked data notifications to all these service hubs, and we are creating now the standards how all these different actors should talk to each other to fulfill all these services and make this really happen. So I had prepared some demos, but because we are short in time, I can't show them, but hopefully on Thursday I will give a boot on how these things could work. Also, we want to have a transparent publication of lifecycle events, because when all these things are happening in this service, there are things registered, there are things indexed, and there are overlay journals, and there are things archived, and things in review. What is left there? And there is some extra data added to the network that's not yet written there. You need to express in an event log the provenance of all the events that are happening on the data that is happening that is created in this researcher pod here. So if you would open one of these event logs, you will see it is registered and certified and published, and all with the technical metadata when it is done, who did it, and in what way. Based on this event log data, you can add a lot of services, like applications can read this and create backlinks between all these services. You can give extra recommendations, like if you publish a data set, please go to this your institutional repo and add it there. Please send it to the DMP to create a data management things. There's also other kind of services, like the people outside of this network. Say, read online on a social network. Say, read some paper or data set, and they don't know if it is this one or this one or this one or this one or this one. Well, based on these event logs, you can show this metadata that shows exactly what has happened to this data set or to this publication. That is quite a nice thing to do. So what we are doing is creating all these specs here. You can read this all in the open. We're also creating software. It's research software, so it's not very good documented, but it works. We have dashboards, we have orchestrators, and we have demonstrators for all these use cases here. So I see that I'm getting out of time. So, well, I hope this all will happen. And if it will not happen, well, I think this could be one of our futures if we don't solve this and this thing in the next few years. So this is my last slide. So I hope there will be some questions or not. And I wish you a next nice rest of the conference. And if you want to learn more about the tools I'm creating on the Twitter, I'm creating monthly and daily cartoon. It's called Solvember, and you can learn more about all the techniques we are using in this project.